हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो वेलकम टू द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग मैकेनिक्स। सो इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन वेरियस फंडामेंटल लॉज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग मैकेनिक्स। ओके, सो आई वुड लाइक टू रिकैप फॉर यू। सो फर्स्ट वॉज न्यूटन्स फर्स्ट लॉ। ओके, second was Newton's second law and third was Newton's third law. Combinedly these are known as laws of motion. Okay, so first law was if a body is in the position of rest or if it is in uniform motion, it will remain in that state, okay, unless and until some external agency or some external forces acting on it. And okay, so this was first law. Second law states force is proportional to rate of change of linear momentum. Okay, and third law was for every action there is equal and opposite reaction. So after that comes Newton's law of gravitation. So till now you might have seen like why Newton was awarded the title of Sir. Usually you will see always there is Sir before the name of Isaac Newton. So his contribution, like immensely he has contributed to the field of mathematics, to the field of physics. You can see we have started from Newton's law only, and many laws he has given throughout his career. Okay, so that's why we have given him a title of Sir. So let us come to what Newton's law of gravity or gravitation, Newton's law of gravitation. So this law states, so I would highly recommend you to please make notes, else you will see the video, you will enjoy, or you may find not enjoy, and after some time you will forget it. So if you are studying seriously, if you want to do well in civil engineering, so it's my humble request to please make your own notes, handwritten notes. There is no replacement for them. Okay, so it states that every body attracts the other body. Okay, this is actually extension of Newton's third law only. So how much will be this force of attraction? It will be same, it will be equal for both the bodies. So let us say this is a body having mass m1, this is a smaller body having mass m2. Okay, and center distance is d. Okay, so this law is telling every body attracts the other body. So this body will attract this body will attract this body. So if this body is attracting the force F, same force is applied by this body on this. So this will be F, and this expression is very common. You might have learn about this in your physics. So what is this force? This capital F was G times m1 m2 divided by d square. Okay, or F is proportional to product of mass divided by square of distance between them. So this G is universal constant. termed as constant of gravitation. Okay, so this law you must have learned in your physics classes. So let us come to the next law, which was law of transmissibility of force. So please pay your attention, this is very important. You will be using this like a lot in your coming courses. So this law of transmissibility is very, very important you to learn. So before going through the example, let me first state, what do you mean by this law? So this law states that the state of, see, because this I am writing along with you because I know it will make the video, you will get something like why sir is writing. I am writing because you can also write. I just want to show how much important the writing is. If you are writing, you are able to get along with your, during writing only you will get to understand many things. 50% you can understand easily while writing. If you are going to like 2-3 times reading, you will like, this is like, it will be very it will imprint on your brain. Okay, so the state of rest or motion of the rigid body is unaltered if a force acting on the body is replaced by another force of same magnitude and direction. Okay, direction, but along anywhere on the body along the line of action of the replaced force. So let me read it for you. This law states that the state of rest or motion of rigid, why I have underlined this, because this is very important. This law is valid for rigid body only, not for deformable bodies. Okay, so the state of rest or motion of rigid body is unaltered. Alter means to change. Unaltered means it is not changing. If a force acting on the body is replaced by another force of same magnitude and direction, acting anywhere on the body along the line of action of the replaced force. Okay, so what we are understanding by this statement, this is a rigid body. Okay, so a force is acting हियर, ओके, सो दिस लाइन इज लाइन ऑफ एक्शन ऑफ फोर्स एफ, लाइन ऑफ एक्शन ऑफ फोर्स एफ. सो दिस लॉ इज टेलिंग इफ वी आर रिप्लेसिंग दिस फोर्स एनी वेयर अलॉन्ग दिस लाइन, सो दिस एक्शन विल रिमेन सेम. ओके, सो लेट मी शो यू हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डू दिस, हाउ वी आर एबल टू डू दिस. सो दिस इज द बॉडी, दिस इज द फोर्स, दिस इज एफ अलॉन्ग दिस. सो वॉट वी आर गोइंग टू डू, this is also f, this is also f. What we have done along this line of action of force f, we have applied two forces which are opposite but equal, force f and force f. Along these are, so if nothing is going to change, okay, this will remain same because f minus f will be zero. So what happened, this f and this f, if we combine, they will become zero. So net effect will be, this was our body, net force F. Okay. So from here we can directly, this means this is equivalent to this. What are the things we have to remember? This body should be rigid body, and this we can do along this line of action only. We cannot move this force here or here somewhere else. This force should be along the line of action of the previous force, which force was being replaced. Okay, so I hope this have cleared some. By when we will be doing some examples, some numericals, we will see this in more detail. Okay, so now comes our last, let me change this page. So here comes our last law, last fundamental law, not last law, last fundamental law of mechanics, which is parallelogram law of forces. This chapter is all about revision. This all the concepts you have learnt in your school, 11th or 12th, 9th or 10th in mechanics basically. So nothing new is there. From next unit, new concepts will be coming. So this is just for your revision, this whole first unit. Okay. So first let me write the statement. This law states that if two forces acting simultaneously on a body at a point are represented in magnitude and direction. Magnitude and direction by the two adjacent, okay. So we have to focus on the keywords, two adjacent sides of a parallelogram. So what is going to happen? Their resultant इज रिप्रेजेंटेड रिप्रेजेंटेड इन मैग्नीट्यूड मैग्नीट्यूड एंड डायरेक्शन मैग्नीट्यूड एंड डायरेक्शन बाय द डायगोनल ऑफ द पैरेललोग्राम. दिस इज नॉट सम मैजिक. ओके दिस इज सिंपल मैथमेटिक्स विच पासिस थ्रू द पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन ऑफ द टू साइड्स रिप्रेजेंटिंग द फोर्सेस. सो इट इज़ वेरी सिंपल. स्टेटमेंट इज़ वेरी बिग बट वॉट इट इज़ ट्राइंग टू से इज़ वेरी सिंपल. दिस लॉ स्टेट दिस इफ टू फोर्सेस एक्टिंग साइमल्टेनियसली ऑन अ बॉडी एट अ पॉइंट आर रिप्रेजेंटेड इन मैग्नीट्यूड एंड डायरेक्शन by the two adjacent sides of a parallelogram their resultant is represented in magnitude and direction by the diagonal of the parallelogram which passes through the point of intersection of the two sides representing the forces. Okay, so what we have understood, let me draw force F1 and a force F2. Okay, so let me complete this. If this is so, I'm trying to draw so what it is saying, this is the complete parallelogram. Parallelogram is what? Opposite sides are equal and they are parallel. So this side is parallel to this, this side is parallel to this. So what is going to be resultant? Resultant will be the diagonal. Okay, diagonal, this is the magnitude, this will be the direction, and it will be passing from the point of intersection of these two forces. If, let me rephrase it, two forces F1 and F2, these are representing the two adjacent sides. Okay, if F1 is here and F2 is here, this law is not going to be valid. Okay, F1, F2, they should be adjacent sides of a parallelogram. So we have to complete the parallelogram. We will draw the diagonal. Which diagonal? The diagonal which is passing through this. There are two diagonals. This is also a diagonal, but we are not interested in that. This law is simply, by this law, resultant will be the diagonal passing through these two sides. So if you are knowing these laws, you will very easily calculate the resultant forces that we will calculate while we will be doing the examples. So this is all for today's lecture. In tomorrow's lecture, we will be seeing some like force system, system of forces, resultant of forces, and free body diagram, Lemmy's theorem. So if you are having some book, some notes, you can always go through them before coming to the lecture. Okay, so this is all for today. Thank you very much. We will be meeting in the next lecture. Thank you.